irons have the bad habit to fall down on the floor, and when it happens, that's the result. So basically every iron is made the same way. The brown wire, which carries the leaf, goes to the thermostat that regulates the temperature of the plate, and then it goes to this thermostat that prevents the overheating of the plate. And then it goes to the resistor, one end of the resistor that heat up the plate. And from here goes to the lamp that signal that the iron is turned on, and then it returns to this blue wire that is the neutral, and the other end of the resistor of the plate goes back to the neutral. And this black wire connects the switch in the handle to the electro valve inside the steam generator to control the release of the steam flow which comes out from this hose. A simple test with a push button can be set up to make sure that the assumptions made about the wiring are correct.
Haha, that's working.
While removing this part from the cord, I've accidentally broken the end of the hose that carries the steam. Internally, there is a sort of spring that prevents the hose to be squeezed. So I've trimmed the end of the hose, then pulled out a little bit of the spring, about 10 millimeters, and cut out to make room for the connector. Next step is making the actual blower. Insert this into this slot, make the switch. Because the nozzle is not heated, I've noticed that a lot of droplets are spitted out with the steam. So to mitigate this problem, I've removed the brass nozzle and replaced it with a plastic pipe inserted into the brass pipe. This helps the thermal insulation, and the plastic pipe is rapidly heated by the steam.